we should probably ask the head of the Muslim Student Association, who's standing right here, if he is against Hezbollah, Hamas, and I think that that's extremely important. May I ask him?
Of course. Let him ask his question.
First of all, you're saying to condemn Hezbollah, Hamas, or just by condemning them, it makes it seem as if the MSA here has some kind of association with those people over there. We have nothing to do with them. It's not my responsibility to denounce anyone. I don't see you denouncing Ann Coulter saying that Jews need to be perfected.
Of course he didn't answer the question. Yeah. Look, there's a lot of people out there. What he said was, his answer to the question was, he doesn't need to condemn terrorist organizations, because that would make it. What?
Let me finish.
Look, we gotta have a little order. Hassan Nasrallah has said that he hopes that the Jews gather in Israel so we won't have to hunt them down worldwide. The head of the Muslim Students Association is comparing that to Ann Coulter's statement that Jews need to be perfected. Now, if you are a Christian, or if you understand what Christianity is about, will understand. You will remember that Jesus said, "I am come to fulfill the law." That Jesus was a Jew who believed that the Mosaic law was imperfect, and that Jews should follow, his gospel. That's what Jesus believed. So for a Christian to believe that Jews should be perfected, that's their religion, that's what they believe. I don't have any problem with that, so long as they don't try to perfect me. I mean, this is what America is, and this is why people in America, if you take the people who live in America, whether it's Croats and Serbs, or Jews and Arabs, or Protestant Irish, or Catholic Irish, in the other parts of the world, they kill each other. But here, we live side by side. Because we all agree, kind of to let everybody do their own thing and, let God sort it out. I don't have any problem with that. I do have a problem with somebody who is inciting millions of people to kill me. And I have a problem with somebody who won't condemn that. And that's you. The National Muslim Students Association was created by the Muslim Brotherhood. If you want to disclose all your funding and what your affiliation means, that's fine with me. In the pamphlet we've distributed, the Muslim Students Association on this campus attacked a Muslim who was condemning terrorism and obstructed his speech. Now, why would you do that if you aren't sympathetic to the terrorists? You can explain it to me and I'll listen. And if you have a reasonable answer, I'll accept it.
No one has ever done that.
And there are no homosexuals in Iran. I know this story.
I'm kind of a hard man. You made me cry because you're a hateful, hateful person.
Can you tell me why you're wearing
a
terrorist headscarf?
I'm not wearing a terrorist headscarf.
What's the boo?
That's a cultural symbol of the people. Do not call it terrorist headscarf.
It is not terrorist. It's not.
100%.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. This is stand up and when there's someone else out there, we're going to tell that person. We'll sit you in the debate.
Here goes all of the... Everybody on the club... Everybody. anybody not in the cult in this audience can see, this was a professor.
This you are professor. Wrong! That is wrong! You cannot attack me on a cult. You know,
did your mother teach you
any
manners, huh? Yeah, my mother taught me manners. We're about to.
That was wrong.
The cult here can't handle any kind of dialogue.
We ask that you do this. If you have a question,
so you all, wait a second. I mean, this is a learning, what they call a teaching moment. We saw a professor pretend, excuse me, we saw a professor who was the faculty advisor of Schools for Justice in Palestine pretend to be a rational person, inviting me to a civil discussion about these issues. And the minute somebody says something that he disagrees with, he explodes like a maniac and storms out of the building. 100% of the Palestinian people have voted for two terrorist parties, two genocidal terrorist parties. Neither the PLO nor Hamas, both of them are sworn to the destruction of the Jewish state. That is genocide right there. Hamas has it written into its charter. These are people who kill their own children by strapping bombs to them and sending them to blow up other little children. The Palestinian people support terrorism. 85%, according to an Arab poll taken on the West Bank, supported the gunman who went into a school library and slaughtered Jewish students studying. Kids just like you. 85% of Palestinians support that. That scarf is a terrorist, genocidal, Hitlerian scarf. And it's not a cultural symbol at all. It's a symbol created by a monster named Yasser Arafat, who stole from the Palestinians themselves $35 billion and put it in a Swiss bank account. Yasser Arafat died with $35 billion in funds earmarked for Palestinian refugees and contributed mainly by the United States and Israel, put it in his Swiss bank account. He was a murderer, he was a terrorist, and if Palestinians had any Palestinian, I should say, with sense, would know that Arafat is their enemy, and that's who created that scarf. That is the symbol. It's Arafat's symbol.